Nuke the fridge.
Nuke the fridge.
Fridge.
I get that response a lot. Man, this film was awesome. Geeks have been trying to analyzing it. It's unlike anything I've seen. This is really, really unique. They're not going to guess what it is until they see it.
No.
So much fantasy, so much awesomeness. How did you come out with this idea, or how did it come about?
Max Landis wrote this crazy script kind of as an homage to me. He dedicated the script to me and brought a lot of what I do as a filmmaker with the cop genre, and then layered in this whole crazy world of fantasy elements. And I hadn't seen it before. I haven't seen it done like this before. So I was up to the challenge.
Definitely. And I noticed in your films, you always include minorities, but you have different kind of minorities. You don't go for the stereotype. Talk of, you know, there's a, like for Hispanics, for instance, you have different kind of Hispanics. You know, how do you do that so seamlessly?
I mean, I grew up in a Latino neighborhood. I mean, it's like, you know, it's the world I know. It's the people I know. So it's what I've seen and what I know, and I just put that into my movies.
You know, I can't express enough how awesome this was. I mean, my eyes was glued to the screen. Can you talk a little bit about the action sequences? Those were like crazy.
They're tough to shoot. They're really tough to shoot. It's like a giant jigsaw puzzle, but each piece is a camera angle, a camera setup, and you have to block it out and then shoot it and hope it goes right, and then find the pieces and put them together when you edit it. It's really about having a great action script. You know, so you write out each little moment and hopefully you just get that cool cause and effect thing going and it flows. But I've shot enough bad action to learn how to not to do it.
Were you a fan of Lord of the Rings? Because this felt like Lord of the Rings really happened.
I mean,
in this universe.
Yeah, I was kind of, you know, a D&D guy growing up and you know, but it's like these elements, these characters, they've been around for a long time.
Okay, so your vision of LA, that was LA, right?
That's LA, man.
You had a few different buildings there, you know, growing up in LA, looking at different. How is that split up? How did you come about that?
Well, the idea is like, you know, the L's are kind of like the one percenters, and there's so much talk now about walls and isolating people and separating people. So, you know, what happens if you build a wall around downtown LA and that's, you know, where the elves live and where all the good shopping is and they got all their sports cars and what would that look like? What would that be like? And then what would it be like on the other side of that wall?
Mm-hmm. Outside of this being a full-length film, there's room for more. TV series sequels, is that something you would like to produce? Maybe get your hand on? I mean, it's Netflix, you're...
You know, it's a big, fun world, and there's a lot of alleys to start running down and looking at, you know. So let's let the audience decide if they want more.
I want more. I'll get 2 subscriptions to Netflix. Thank you very much, man.
Thanks, man.
Thank you very much.
All right.
That was awesome. It was awesome.